fellow film lovers, never ever, even with the worst provocation, attempt to do three things. The first, judge the mood of your spouse. Two, judge the mind of a politician. And three, judge the traffic of Madras. I must confess that I miserably failed in all three counts. A person who sits, who resides exactly six doors away from me, Mr. Maniratnam, is already here. His judgment was perfect. Mine was wrong. I apologize, Shivi and the rest of you for sauntering in so late, but that's that. Take a forensic pathologist or a man who studies the scene of crime. What he needs is the scene to study. An archaeologist needs a site to go and dig. Similarly, film historians need a film to see. Most people think film restoration and film preservation is for the films of M.K. Tyagaraja Bhagavadar and P.U. Chinnappa and stuff like that. No. We have lost a large number of films produced post the MGR era, which is post-70s. In fact, the percentage of films lost is higher in the post-70s era vis-a-vis the earlier part. Yes, Tamil Nadu and the South, because Tamil Nadu was representing the South for quite a while till the mid-70s, you will find that we have been amiss, very, very lackadaisical about our approach towards the safety and preservation of our films. Even today in the modern era, with digital filmmaking as Mr. David had suggested, people think that the moment they have a film on their some hard disk, they have preserved it. I'm sure the faculty here are going to tell the younger filmmakers today that that is not the end of it. It's probably the beginning of the story. Even digital films, digital photographs. The other day my wife was mentioning, I've got some lovely snaps in the mobile. I said, well, which mobile? Oh. I said, did you upload it to the computer at least? No. What happened? No, but I sold that photograph. Then what did you do? That fellow removed everything from the hard disk. That means he removed it. It's gone. So, ignorance on the part of the filmmakers, the owners of the copyright, if we can locate them, all these have contributed to the tremendous loss in the post-70s era. To the members of the press, I'd like you to please publicize that films have got to be saved. Why? 12 years ago, I gave a lecture on the city of Madras as seen through the lens of a cinema camera. I showed people shots of the beach road from a 1938 film called Tyagabhoomi. No one could recognize the beach. I showed them the present day Gemini Circle before even Gemini started his Gemini studios there. It was called the Cathedral Road Circle. No one could recognize that place. Old snapshots of Besan Nagar in older films of Mr. Balachandar. Why? You go down Mount Road and take that song, Madras, Nalla Madras. 50% of the place we can't recognize. 90% of the cinema halls in Anna Salai have gone. Nobody knows even the facade of how Wellington Theatre looked. The last of the Mohicans, Shanti, has also gone. Casino alone remains intact. and it remains intact because of a land ownership dispute between the lessee and the temple authorities who leased it out in way back in 1938. And therefore, the theater still stands, the last of the Art Deco buildings. Many an architect has gone there and started taking snaps of it. Why? Because they are very, very sure that it's going to come down. Shortly, you wouldn't know how Madras looked. And the only way you can get that look is through the old films. How did people dress up way back then? How did people behave? What was the manner in which they spoke to each other? To a certain degree, yes, films may have exaggerated it, but at least you get an idea of what's happening. The other day, Shivendra rang me up from Bombay and said, "News dekha?" I said, "Yeah." RK Studios. I said, "Yeah." Then he gave me the sad story of how every single costume of Mr. Raj Kapoor and Nargis, right up to his Mera Naam Joker outfit, everything got burnt in that huge flames, destroyed, fire. Are we doing the right thing? I know Mr. Maniratnam had a problem when he tried to get Nayakan, how much he had to run to get the originals. I'm sure he's going to talk about it. And Nayakan is not a very old film, boss. Please. If that is going, take the plight of the earlier films. Most of us are reduced to, somebody had the good sense to convert a DVD and that becomes the master now, not the film negative, not even a dupe negative, not the positive, not a print. Somebody had done a DVD, appa, at least that is available. There are so many great songs of people like Chandrababu which I have been trying to locate because the film is not available. No film, no song. What is available is the audio, not the video. Most of you are aware of this song where he sings Kannile Kandadum Kanavai Ponadu Kadile Kettadum Kadai Polanadu. You can't locate that song. Give me a visual of that song. Give me one single still from that song. And all these are post 60s and 70s films. The silent era, we made films which disputed. Some say 1917 was when Natarajan Muthaliar released his film. Some say it is 18. Some say it is 16. 16 is when he started his company. That I have records. But the release date is still under question because if it is 1917, then this year should be the year we celebrate the centenary of cinema in the South. It's probably next year. Conveniently, we can push it to next year only because we haven't done anything about the celebrations. And there is evidence to show it was released in 1918 at the Kinema Central, Gaiti, and a few other theatres. But nothing is available in the silent era from 1918, we'll take it as 1918, till 1934. Not one single film of the silent era is available, barring a few reels from a film called Marthandavarman. That too, because it was happily found safe outside the country. Apne yahan to, we would have killed it. Films of that era were even more explosive in terms of not the content but the sheer nature of silver nitrate. Where do we go to study? The other day somebody came and said, "Sir, I'm doing a documentary on Natarajan Muthaliar. Can you help?" I said, "Yes, I can help." "How?" "There is a 1971 interview of him. This is it." He said, "That I have, sir." "That is it." "What?" I said, "That is it. That is all the material available." "All right." Somehow I sat, located, traced his family. I go to their house. His grandson-in-law is available. I asked him, "You have any photograph of the old man?" "No." "Something about the old man?" "Nothing." "Your memory?" "Not much." "What can you tell me?" He pulls out this 1971 interview and says, "This is all I can tell you." And that man is the founder of films, not just for Tamil, he is the founder of films in South India. He is the Dada Saheb Phalke for us in the South. And we don't know a thing. If that is the case for founders, then where is Mr. Maniratnam? And where is Mohan Raman? So let us please pass on the message that films are a part of social history. Let us, you don't have to like the guy. It could have great shots of Bangalore city. It could have great shots of Hyderabad, Cochin. Even now the pristine beaches of Kerala can be seen in a film like Chemmeen. A sight which is gone now. Just to know what our country looked like 50 years ago, 60 years ago, during the times of your parents or grandparents. It's all gone. Nobody remembers Gemini Circle before the flyover. And before the flyover, for 30 years stood the famous Gemini Studios with the Bugle Boys heralding entertainment. And before that was the studio of K. Subramaniam, who made that film Tyagabhoomi, and he shot just outside his studio. And that's how I got the shot of the Gemini Circle. So please pass on the message, my friends in the media, that our films need to be preserved. What prevents preservation? One, awareness on the part of filmmakers that films have to be preserved. Two, the extraordinary high cost of preserving these films for a person who is not heavily into film production. He may be a one-off producer or a man who made two films or three films. But he goes. He packs his bag and goes back to his village, leaving his prints in a lab, which after a while closes down and throws all the films out. What is the answer? Is the answer the National Film Archives in Pune? It should be. But is it? Recently read a report about how films were stored in gunny bags and thrown in various places in Pune. I was so disturbed because there are three films in Pune which are of historical significance to Tamil-speaking population. The first is the first film of M.K. Tyagaraja Bhagavathar and the first film of K. Subramaniam as a director called Pavalakkudi. Film Archives Pune alone has a print. The second, the only record of an actress called T.P. Rajalakshmi, who was the first feature film director of India, lady feature film director of India, not South India, India. She was the heroine, she was the producer, she was the director, she was also the, and she was called the Cinema Rani. Her film is available, Madurai Veeran, not the Madurai Veeran made by MGR. There are several other lovely old films available there. I was hoping that they are not the ones which have been stored so brilliantly in gunny bags and cans all open everywhere. Some photographs came, I was so disturbed. So gentlemen of the press and my friends and the 52 students out here, pass on the message that films have to be preserved. There are people, great people like Shivendra, who have taken off the burden of the economics of storing away from the producer. They are willing to preserve things at their expense, at their cost, for you, on your behalf, at their premises. So no longer is the expense going to be a factor. It is just the willingness to store, a willingness to preserve the past. Preserving the past is paying respect to our elders, our forefathers, path breakers. If there was no K. Subramaniam, if there was no K. Balachandra, if there was no K. Bhagiraj or K. Bharati Raja, if there was no Balu Mahendra, if there is no Mahendra, then there is no Maniratnam. They were the people who forged the way for all of us. the only way we can honor them and their memory is to preserve at least the works they did. So let us all put our hands together and support this movement for preserving, protecting, and in the end, enjoying those great films. Thank you very much.
In and Out Cinema ku subscribe pannunga.
In and Out Cinema va subscribe pannunga.
In and Out Cinema ku subscribe pannunga.
In and Out Cinema ku padivu pannunga. Damn it,
piracy ஒழிக்கிறது எவ்வளோ முக்கியமான விஷயமோ அதை விட ரொம்ப முக்கியமான விஷயம் இன் அண்ட் அவுட் சினிமாஸை சப்ஸ்கிரைப் பண்ணுறது வேறு வழியில் சொல்லி தான் ஆகணும்.